Hello everyone and welcome back to the garden. See, we have these ranunculus blooming and you know donations aren't open and I've been kind of wondering what am I going to do with all these ranunculus. I've been giving them away and all kinds of different things. But I recently got an interesting request over on Patreon and I said, "Hey, that sounds kind of fun. I might as well give that a try and see if I can do it." The request was for a ranunculus wreath, just a wreath made of straight up solid ranunculus. I've never attempted anything like this before. I have no experience in floral arranging, so disclaimer there. If you are a florist, I'm sorry for what you're about to witness, but if you have any helpful constructive comments, be sure to leave them in the description below if you'd like. I always appreciate it. So let's get right on into this. It could be a disaster, you know, we'll have to wait and see what happens. The first thing I did is I picked a bunch of ranunculus. I decided I want this to be pink and orange. I thought that was a nice color combination, so I got a bunch of pink and orange flowers. There's also some yellow ones back there. I kind of had those in case I needed more because honestly, I did not know how many I was going to need. Then I ordered my supplies. I think most of my supplies came from Hobby Lobby. I have some Oasis floral foam, some 11-inch zip ties, some waterproof floral tape, and a 24-inch wire wreath form. This was about $40 altogether. They do have, you know, wreath forms with the floral foam already on it, but the biggest one I found was 12 inches, and it was like $60, and I was just like, that is too expensive. Also, we're using floral foam. Please do your research on floral foam if you're going to use it. I personally don't like to use it. I'm using it in this video. It was a request. You know, lots of chemicals and stuff in there. I don't think they're biodegradable. Just not my cup of tea. But again, make your own informed decisions. This is all about you. The first thing I'm going to do is I'm just cutting these into like 2-inch blocks. And I'm going to place them around this wreath form. And as I cut them to 2 inches, I was like, that is way too thick. So I went back and I cut these blocks in half actually. And they're about 1 inch thick. I ended up using just a total of maybe 1.5 bricks for this. You can see they're not completely even. You know, they're different widths or thicknesses, but hey, this is our first time. We're just gonna go with it. I plopped these into a bucket of water and let them soak up the water. Just read the instructions on the side of the thing to do that. Then I situated them on this wire form, and I'm just using a zip tie to kind of secure this into place. Now, obviously, these zip ties, that stuff, that foam, the zip ties kind of crunch into it. But the main thing I wanted to do with the zip ties is kind of just secure them in place a little bit so that I can move them around in different places when I'm kind of spacing out the final location of them. Here in a second, you'll see. So I have these kind of 1-inch thick, just wet foam bricks that I am putting on here. I've definitely learned a lot in doing this for the first time. I learned a lot. There are some things I would do different if I were to do this again, but overall, I'm actually really pleased because, like I said, I don't have any experience doing this. It was just very much a, hey, let's try it, let's videotape it, and see what happens. This wreath form was a little bit flimsy. I think I would reinforce that if I did it again. So see, we have these on zip ties and we can just kind of move them around and space them as we, you know, kind of think would work. They don't have to touch each other because that gap is going to be filled in with flowers here soon. So it's not really a big deal. Now, I didn't film this next part because it was very difficult to do. But you see, I took my waterproof floral tape and I just went around all of those bricks and the wire and everything, and I secured them in place. Luckily, that tape was very strong and very adhesive. I'm really glad that that worked out well. And now all of my little bricks are kind of secured into place. They're not perfectly aligned and everything, and that's fine. And you can see there's floral foam and water all over the place on my background. This was a mess. I was a lot messier than I had expected. But fortunately, we got through it enough to where I was able to begin putting the ranunculus flowers onto the floral foam. And again, this is really the first time I'm ever doing this. I'm using a lot of different ranunculus at a different stages of opening. Ideally, they should all be kind of tight and compact. But, you know, it is what it is. We don't live in an ideal world. And this wreath is just for me, so I'm really, really pleased with it. I'm just snipping the stems at the base of the flower, leaving a little bit of stem there to go into the floral foam. When you're putting it in there, I like to kind of put it in there kind of straight up and down a little bit so that they're not, you know, the stems aren't running into each other, because that does become an issue a little bit later when we get this thing full of flowers. Fortunately, the ranunculus stems are nice and strong and tough, which makes them very easy to use with this floral foam. I was really happy with that. I just filled in the pink until we kind of had a base layer of pink around the top, and then we started kind of filling in the spaces around the inside. You see the green on the inside and around the outside, using a lot of these orange flowers more sparingly, which I think looked really, really nice. We had a lot of really pretty orange flowers. And, you know, we made progress. It was starting to look better and better. This is at the point that I was starting to feel really, really optimistic about it. And I was just like, man, I hope this works out when I pick it up, because this thing is going to be so heavy. Even with just the foam bricks on it, it was very heavy. I would definitely reinforce that wire reform again if I were to do this again. But overall, wow. And so actually I had, my dad came over and he was holding it up for me. He's the one you see holding it up in this video. I am so incredibly surprised. Look at it. It looks like a freaking floral wreath. I attached it to this wire trellis to kind of hang up a little better. I'm leaving this on the wire trellis and I'm just going to see how long it lasts out in my backyard to see what kind of life we have for this in the backyard. For the first time that I've ever done this, any kind of floral arranging, like fancy floral arranging, I would consider this fancy floral arranging like this, I am so pleased with how this turned out. And again, you know, if you already have the flowers, $40, floral wreath, boom. Who knows how much this would cost if you ordered it from a florist. I'm sure it would be way above and beyond my price range. That's for certain. What do you guys think? Do you guys like this one? I am so pleased with how this one came out. I appreciate you watching this. I really do. And, you know, since I've been kind of struggling with getting into the mood of making flower arrangements lately, so since this video was a little bit of a short one, about 7 minutes for this, what I wanted to do is go ahead and show you guys some of the other kind of springtime flower arrangements that I've been making here in the backyard, because, I mean, it's not really long enough for a separate video. In this, we have our first arrangement. We have these Victoria's Secret tulips. They are very beautiful dark, and we have some ornamental kale going in as our base. This ornamental kale has been totally awesome for a kind of foliage flower this year. I know I always struggle for early season foliage, and I am totally digging this ornamental kale. It's been so reliable, and it's got such a nice texture, and the different kind of tones of just purples and whites and pinks and everything. Very, very nice, especially going with these Victoria's Secret tulips are very pretty as well. They're parrot tulips technically, but you can see they're more kind of ruffly instead of something that's like, you know, feathered looking. I just paired these with some ranunculus. These were the orange ranunculus out of the Amandine Pastel Lemon Mix, and kind of arranged them together. I really, really like this coral color with the purple tulips and everything. And I just put some late season daffodils in there with that, and I think it looks so incredibly cute. You know, I'd always try to kind of get better at arranging flowers. It's not really one of my strong points, I feel like, but I really, really enjoyed how this one turned out. And the daffodils were super fragrant, so this one smelled really, really good sitting on my kitchen table, which I really, really loved. I always kind of seem to struggle early in the season like this trying to make flower arrangements, because it seems like there's never enough, you know, different plant materials to go together with other plants and whatnot. So I wanted to try to make another flower arrangement. This one I started with mint, and also using some of these fringed Cummins tulips and the scented stock, which we've been growing. And you can see I just used some Icelandic poppies, and I popped a couple of the geranium daffodils into it. This one smelled amazing as well. This one's a little bit different. I usually don't really go for purple flower arrangements. Usually I'm all about the pastels and everything, but I definitely wanted to use some of those Icelandic poppies before they were done blooming. The next one I made was this kinglet apricot calendula. It's that scabiosa calendula that I've been telling you guys about. And I just used some sundist daffodils, a little bit of wallflower, and some of those antique shades pansies. And this thing is like, boom, yellow. Did you want a yellow bouquet? Here you go. Not much variation in the yellow one, but definitely a lot of variation in what's going on in the garden all at once. Like, look at all the different colors. That's incredible. It's just been kind of fun to get back into the groove of playing with different flowers. Next, we have another one. This is the Coral Supreme Peony. I thought for sure that these had been ruined by the snow, but look, they're so beautiful. I cannot get enough of these beautiful, incredible peonies. They are so gorgeous. They are really something special. I would love to have a farm, but mix these with some yellow ranunculus and some of those Chianti pansies are finally blooming. I'll show you guys those in a later video. They don't look anything like the packet of seed, the pictures I've seen online, with a little bit of ornamental cabbage in there, ornamental kale. Very pretty. Also made a bucket arrangement, yellow flowers, yellow ranunculus. Basically, all I did was put a bunch of the different Dutch irises into a bucket of yellow ranunculus and gave it away. I was like, here's your flower arrangement. I hope you like it. I think it looks really cool. To be fair, I think it looks very, very neat. I love how the Dutch iris go together with the yellow ranunculus with just the different yellow tones. There will be a Dutch iris tour sometime soon, hopefully, if you guys are interested in that. I don't really have that many varieties of Dutch iris, but hopefully I have enough to make a video out of it. I might combine it with like a pansy video instead, I'm not sure. Last but not least, we have these chamello flowers. They are beautiful. Mix those with some scented stocks and some kale. Beautiful. That's it for this video. I know that it was quick. I do really appreciate you watching. As always, let me know what your favorite thing was down in the comments below and all that good stuff. All the links to Patreon and our blog and everything are down there as well. I am so appreciative that you have taken the time to watch this. It really does mean a lot to me as I try to grow our little channel. I hope that you're having such an incredible day, and I will talk to you guys later. Bye, y'all.